It's the first round of the Australian Open, my first opportunity to get Radwanska a Grand Slam title. Hi, I am Ian. This is episode 4 of Grand Slam Agger, and we are taking on Jana Sepelova in the very first round. For those of you who haven't really been following this series, we actually got obliterated in the Brisbane Open against Li Na. We lost in 3 sets, but it should have been in almost 2 sets because we were crap. So we're taking on Sepelova. Now, she is a bit of a nothing. She's ranked 79th on this game. In the real world, she got as high as 50th, I believe it was. And I think now she's ranked something like 138 or 140 or something. I'm sure someone will be able to correct me there. So she's been a little inconsistent. She's very, very young, though. She's only 20 in this game, so she's only 22, 23, something like that in the real world. She won something like 5 ITF titles at the moment, but she hasn't won anything in the WTA Tour. And as you can see, her forehand is her biggest weakness. So that's something that I'm going to really have to try and exploit. Really going to try and constantly get her on that forehand, because her backhand is actually very, very good. It's not much worse off than Li Na. Her serve is also very good too. Now, she does have very low net presence and her volleys aren't fantastic. She can't counter at all by the looks of things. So that's going to have to be something that I utilize as well. Try and get those drop shots because her net presence is so poor. But otherwise, it's going to be onto the forehand and the drop shots. I've also got a really cool screen wipe that I'm going to be using. How cool is that? We are underway. So I fully expect this game to be a bit of a walk over here for the first round.
Net for service.
As it looks like we're being broadcast into China. Well, looks like, is that China or Taiwan? That was her backhand. As you can see, she's got real power on it. Been too challenged so far. So we've got the number 6 seed actually in the Australian Open, which is pretty damn good. It puts us in a real opportunity. And I don't know if she's going to get there in time. How good was that drop shot? That was perfectly placed. I ought to really capitalize on her poor net presence if I can. Oh, I'll give her that one though. That was a fantastic shot. I didn't think she was actually going to get there. Keeping her on that forehand at all times. But that was a poor unforced error by yours truly. And that puts us into break point straight away. Mm-hmm. She's trying to do the same thing as me, actually. Keep me on my forehand. Oh, and that was a bad error. Yes. She was very, very lucky there. And she's won it from an unforced error. Is she going to get there in time? No, she's not. Another huge air swing by Radwanska. I really have to cut them out of my game. I really, really do. But I'll take the ace to put us in a really good position to win this game. That was a clinical finish. She pushed us right up to the net, which is something that I haven't been made to do at all, really, in the few games that I've played. Once this game's sort of, you know, beyond the, you know, the point of Sepulveda being able to win, I might start sort of practicing coming up to the net and trying to win on the volleys. She's going to reach this one. Another huge air swing. 15. She has got a very good serve, so I wouldn't be surprised if she gets an ace or two in this match. Oh, lovely. That's the sort of mistakes you need to get her into. Just keep returning it to her forehand and she'll eventually stuff up. Back to break point. We had her in break point the first time she served, but she still won. And that's it. That's break point. And that puts us in a commanding position now. I did have a little look at the draw in the previous episode, and I believe there's a strong possibility, because that was a great shot, there's a strong possibility that we could be playing Olivia Rogoska again. And I also believe that Lee Na is in our part of the draw, so this could be a complete carbon copy to the Brisbane Open. That's poor old Sepulveda here. Oh no, that was terrible. The other thing I looked at as well is Radwanska and Sepulveda have never actually played one another, which I find quite surprising. 40-15. Fantastic. Sepulveda was set right at the back of the baseline there. I think she thought we were just going to get into a power baseline sort of struggle, tussle, but that drop shot fooled her completely. And that was another great shot by Radwanska. Sepulveda's never actually progressed past the second round of the Australian Open. She hasn't progressed past the second round in the French or the US Opens either. She got to the third round in Wimbledon, however. And that was 2013, I think, something like that. But that's as far as she's managed. As we're just starting to come into our own now. Commentator's curse strikes again. 15-30. That was a great backhand shot. That's why you don't really want to get her on that backhand. Because she can win points so easily with it. That brings back nightmares of the match against Li Na. As we got break point yet again. That was a fantastic winner there as we break her for the second time. And it puts us in a commanding position to serve for the set here. We're up 5-1.
Net for service.
Let's try and get one over the net, shall we? I thought I'd try something different, but perhaps I shouldn't have done that. Again, she was forced to come in. The poor net presence really letting her down. So I don't want to get her on that backhand. I've been so concerned about getting an ace that I've actually been aiming to her left on this side, just like that, because it gives her a chance to use her backhand, which is obviously her strength. She's got me moving. Tried to go for the glorious winner there. Oh, and she's juiced it up. Deuce.
Thank you.
this to win the set. My goodness. I really need to fix my positioning. Oh, oh, come on. That brings it back to juice for the third time in this game. Radwanska's getting fired up now. I think she wants to end this. And we do it. We win the set. So, the first serves, we dominated. Sepulova couldn't do anything. Only got 50% in. 17 winners to 10. Unforced errors, 12 to 7. So, unforced errors still hugely in our favour. Other than that, it's been a little bit one-sided. We need to get our first serve speed up. We've usually been getting around 170, so that's something that we do need to look at. Otherwise, it's been all us entirely. Just got us on the run. And that was the wrong button scheme again, but that lob worked perfectly. I am slowly but surely remembering how to lob. But the controls are actually the wrong way around. I don't know if I can change that, but I've probably been playing this game too long to change it. We're basically up is, you know, just behind the net, and down is the back of the court. And so it is a little bit difficult to remember sometimes. That's a great drop shot, but she's going to get there. And oh, her volley let her down there. But yet again, I perhaps should have considered lobbing just straight away rather than trying to get past her with a power shot. This is where I say we've taken a stranglehold on this game, but I know I'll probably fault now. But thankfully Radwanska won't fault because Sepulova will do it for us. So we've broken her to start the second set. Oh, lovely shot. A 12th backhanded winner. When I don't completely air swing, I do manage to get some great shots in. As this is turning into a little bit of a carbon copy from the game against Radwanska at Brisbane.
Second serve.
Because in it, Radwanska won her first serve and then Ben did nothing in the second set at all, and that's exactly how this has gone. She won her first serve and then we started to go into a sort of, you know, take a stranglehold on the game. And I don't think Sepulova has actually won a point in this set yet. Commentator's curse. My goodness, commentator's curse yet again. I should probably just shut up. Let me know in the comments. Should I just shut up? Just play the game? Unbelievable. Radwanska has some real power winners. I think that was my biggest issue against Li Na, is I was trying to hit them back at power. But Li Na has such precision that it was sort of pointless. As I'm really moving Sepulveda around the court. 15-30. I hope I don't face Li Na in the later rounds. We'll have a good look at the tournament after this match. That wasn't a fantastic drop shot. So that was a great winner. And the double fault wins it for us, so we're up 3-love in the second set. I really have to cut down these unforced errors. Not that I've been giving up lots of them in any of the games I've played, but... particularly on the return after the serve, I just knock it out far too frequently.
30-15.
But she's not going to get to that one. That was a fantastic backhand winner.
40-15.
Yes. As easy as that. Sepulveda had no answer. I think even the crowd responded positively to that play. As this result is ours to lose now. Where'd you get that one from?
15-love.
Sepulveda seems to have notched up a gear. It was very nearly an ace. I only sort of reacted to it at the last second. She was unlucky to hit the net to still give us an opportunity in this game. Oh, unlucky. You're not going to win that easily, Sepulveda. That was a fantastic winner.
Yes.
Shouldn't have hit to a backhand. That was a bad idea. That was a mistake. And Sepulveda's got advantage for it. just done it again. Oh yeah, Sepulveda wasn't expecting that. 120k an hour winner.
Net for service.
And that puts us into advantage. Break point yet again. Surprised Radwanska managed to get there then. And that one. Let's get her moving. Oh, I was trying to lob, and yet again I moved the controller in the wrong direction, and that brings back juice. Sepulveda's just prolonging the inevitable now, surely. Break point for the second time. And that's how you do it. Brought her to the net and then put it a million miles away from her as we're serving for the match now, the set and the match. Must admit, Sepulveda is one of those names that... a rare double fault. Yeah, Sepulveda is one of those names that I've heard before, but when I actually found out how poor she is in terms of her ranking, I was really surprised. I thought she was a lot higher up than she was. I mean, so in this game, she's 76th or something, and in 2014, she did get up to 50th in the rankings. But she's really done nothing. She hasn't won any WTA titles. She's won 5 ITF titles. And I don't know why I've heard her name before. She must have had a game or two against sort of Serena Williams or someone like that, which is why I know the name. Oh, that was beautiful. Came off the net, but Radwanska wasn't phased and just kept that one in. After the double fault put us love 30 down, we're back to 30 all. I'm just trying to return it. Oh, she could be breaking us here. I'd rather not get broken. That's juice. Second game in a row it goes to juice. Sepulveda's certainly putting up more of a fight than Radwanska did, but that's a great winner. Serving for the match now. And she's got nothing to that one. 6-1, 6-love in the end. It was a carbon copy of the game against Radwanska in Brisbane. We were not phased at all, were we? First serve, points won. We totally dominated us. She had really didn't have any reply to our serves. 21 unforced errors cost her big time in the end, and the 35 winners to 15 certainly helped. But that rare double fault kept the game longer than it should have done, which was just under the hour in the end. 58 total points won to the Sepulveda's 27. So we are into the second round. There's confirmation. And we are. We're taking on Olivia Rogoska, who won 6-2, 6-3 against Monica Puig. So I don't think they actually say Puig. I say Puig because of baseball. There's a baseball player called Puig, but I think they say sort of like Puig or something. Who knows? Where's Monica from? Because that'd help. She's from Puerto Rico, so I'm going to say Puig, and she looks awful. So we have got Rogoska again. Now, the last time we played her, we won 6-1, 6-love. Exactly the same as the result against Sepulveda, where Rogoska won her first serve and then did nothing after that. So in terms of our draw, we've got Kvitova, Zhang Kerber, who, of course, won the Australian Open in 2016. So we could be facing someone like her. But if we do get through Rogoska, which I think we will, then it looks like we've got either Zhang or Fitchman. Sharon Fitchman. She's got to be German. Or she's from Canada. There you go. I mean, she doesn't look anything special at all there, does she? So that it does look like most likely we could be playing Zhang, who is pretty poor too. She's almost the opposite of who we've just played, you know, with a bit more backhand power. So that's the match. So join me in a couple of days' time for our second encounter with Rogoska. Pop a like on there for me if you enjoyed today's episode. And if you've got any feedback, by all means comment. I always read it. I always take the advice on board. So thanks for watching, guys.